folks. ScrambledO checking in.
All right, quick video for you guys today. Back out here at the base camp, and today I brought a shovel because what I did last video was did me a little rock cooking. Cooked up a strip steak on a rock. The rock was set on rounds that burned, so it wasn't really a good permanent way to cook on a rock. So today I took a shovel, dug out a little keyhole fire pit right here. Here's my normal fire pit. It was about to here, and I went ahead and dug it out, make it a little bit bigger. And then I took it and made a little channel, a little keyhole area right here, so I can do small fires, and I just set the rock right here. I've got this keyhole area dug out long enough so that the rock can sit here, and hopefully I'll get some airflow to come through here and maybe back through here to keep the fire going. But yeah. As you guys can see, I've already got my fire prep, rocking that Hidden Woodsman ruck. Nice. Some more fire prep, hack, small kindling, feather it also, double hack. Using that little Mora today. Man, you can't beat these little knives, love them. Got some other wood here, and for breakfast, you're probably asking yourself, Scram, you've done a whole lot of breakfast videos. What could you possibly be cooking up this time? Well, I was actually at the grocery store the other day, and I saw biscuits and gravy. It's stuff we make at home. And I'm gonna do it kind of like sous vide. I'm gonna put the package, the plastic package of gravy inside of my mess kit that has water in it. So it's gonna slowly heat it up. I got some English muffins I'm gonna cook on the rock, some bacons. So let's try this keyhole fire pit out, see if it works and gets cooking. Alright, it took a little bit of babying, but I've got it going. And yeah, the issue is airflow. It's hard to get airflow down into this little fire pit. But yeah, I just blew on it a little bit. With the width of this fire hole, fire pit, whatever you call it, I can set that rock across, but I still think it'd be better off to give the fire a little bit of space to breathe. So I'll probably still use a couple of rounds on the edges of the fire pit to elevate the rock up off of it. But I'll make sure that I pick the oldest, wettest, nastiest rounds that won't burn. That way the rock doesn't drop. All right, the way that I got this packaged up, the way that I brought this out is, here's my sausage gravy. It's just Bob Evans stuff. It comes in this plastic bag, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my little mess kit pot, cook pot, and I'm gonna put water in it, heat the water up, and set this inside the water to just slowly warm it up. And then I've got two English muffins that I'm gonna toast on my rock, and I've got a nice slab of bacon that I'm gonna try to cook on the rock surface as well. But I gotta get this fire going good. I got to get the rock up early so that it has enough time to heat up for my cooking. All right, so I mentioned it last video that I could use that cooking tripod I've got above this. Just because there's a rock over it doesn't mean there's not enough heat coming up to heat up coffee or oatmeal or something like that. So I'm gonna slide that little cooking tripod above it and put my little dangler, my little pot hanger above it so I can start heating up this sausage gravy. All right, so it's kind of like a sous vide where you heat up all your ingredients inside water, inside of a plastic bag. I'm gonna do the same thing here with the sausage gravy. I do want to get it warmed up. So I'm gonna dump in a bottle of water, put my gravy in it, and then go set it up over this fire. It's a pretty sweet setup, because on this side I got all this free space down here so I can kind of feed fuel back in underneath of it like this. It works pretty good. Alright, well, I think it's actually about time to start throwing this bacon on, because my little sausage gravy sous vide is hot. It's ready. So I pulled the tripod off. As you guys can see, I pulled the tripod off to the side. That way it's not burning plastic into my food, giving me brain damage or whatever it does. So yeah, I think it's time to put the bacon and the English muffins on the rock and test it out, see if it's hot enough to cook on. All right, got the sausage gravy warm enough. Got my, oh man, over spilling. Got my English muffins toasted. Show you these up close. A little bit of toastiness to it. Ooh, that's how I like it. So the premise of this meal, the reason I thought it'd be a good idea is because I thought I could just cut the corner off of this bag, squirt a little gravy onto the biscuits. All right, so I take my biscuit and my gravy, just cut the corner off the bag. That way there's no cleanup, there's no dishes or anything to do. Put that gravy on it, then you got yourself a nice little bite-sized snack. Easy, no cleanup. Oh my. So yeah, that's the reason I thought this would be a good idea. It's because there's no cleanup. You just squeeze the bag onto the biscuit. Yeah, and eat it. Got some bacon. Raw cooked bacon. One piece of bread down, free to go. So you guys know, sausage, biscuits, and gravy. Old time favorite. I just did the easy cheat code way by buying the pre-made stuff that all you gotta do is heat it up. No bacon casualties today, boys. No bacon lost. None dropped in the fire. I got a nice dark brick red to an amber color. The bacon be crispy, boy. All right, I'm about to get crazy. Bacon, sausage, muffin, sandwich. All right, got the little muffins. Squirt a little gravy. Not a lot, you don't want to get this thing crazy sloppity, but you still want that flavor. Then you take a piece of your bacon. Put it on there, like that. Little hashtag with the bacon. That should be good. No, I need more gravy on top. It's kind of a flat little sandwich. But that's the bacon English muffin gravy sandwich. Just as you would expect. Fire, amazing. We're gonna get crazy. It's that little half pipe right there. We're gonna drop in some gravy on the bread half pipe. Yeah. It turns out, when I started Bushcraft Breakfast Series, that I was actually doing food that was a little bit too difficult to make. So like this is instant sausage gravy, and last time I did, a couple times ago, I did apples in bacon grease with cinnamon, and the last like four breakfast videos I did, oh man, that's it. So if you want breakfast camping breakfast foods, go back to the last four or five videos I did of cooking. You know, they probably all have bacon in them. That's the common thread, is that when you cook something in bacon grease, it's really good. This is way better than I expected. I've had sausage biscuits and gravy in probably over a year. All right, boys, well, I think that does it for me today. Just finished up my breakfast and I ate it way too fast. My stomach is not feeling good now. But I did like the breakfast because of the way that it tasted. I like the flavor of it. Really good idea, very simple, no cleanup afterwards. Whew, amazing. And also, this little keyhole fire pit thing I got going on is epic. It's awesome, it's perfect. It worked perfectly and it worked beautifully. So main fire pit, and then this little area over here for cooking. Keyhole fire pit. Got these little rocks, and yeah, as you guys can see, it is cracking. The rock is cracking, so hopefully it doesn't break into a bunch of pieces, because this is awesome. That does it for me today, guys. I appreciate you guys watching, and until next time, ScrambledO signing off.